Welcome to the Eric Hernandez Show. Today's guest speaker is W.E.B. Du Bois. So, Mr. Du Bois, tell me a little about yourself.
Well, I'm an American civil rights activist, a pan-Africanist, a sociologist, a historian, an editor, and first and foremost, a realism author. I was born in 1868, in a turbulent time in America. You may have seen some of my writings, such as Souls of the Black Folk, Strivings of the Negro People, and The Comet.
Well, isn't that a mouthful? Would you care to talk about your writings?
Well, I tend to focus mostly on racism and the discrimination of my people. My main technique to bring in attention to this serious issue is an appeal to pathos and logic. I attempt to try to reason with people as to why racism against my people is wrong, and I try to hit soft spots in their heart, in the process.
I see. I have here a piece of your new writing. It would be a pleasure to hear you read from it.
What is it that draws men to condemn those they view as beneath them? This is an unasked question that has long plagued me. How is it that a man can treat another like an animal solely based upon the color of his skin? Outrages continue to occur towards my people despite insistence to cease. As a young boy, never once did I see myself as a disease of which many have sought to make me believe. It was not until a boy of 12 that I first realized the implications others had towards my people. Upon entering a dining house, the sign regarding Negroes avoided my father's eyes. Angered eyes that bore the centuries of prejudice upon my family and I. It was not till then that I understood the difference between the others and us. For the mere reason that our skin color was dark, we had been forced and barred from merely enjoying the simple pleasure of dining. Despite spending much of my life attempting to cure the ailments of others, putting any discrimination I held aside, I was still looked upon with contempt as on that day. Looking at the history of the world that we all live upon makes question as to why some are subjugated to be beneath others. The Romans considered the Catholics a nuisance, treating them with brutal treatments. Why is that now they no longer treat them as they did before, but with respect and acceptance? At the time, the mere ability of free thought was punishable by law, even here in America, shedding upon the amendments that we so strongly base our lives upon. Why is it that these rules governing society have changed? The rules change to allow acceptance corresponding to the changes in society itself. How does this differentiate from the current situation of the black man? Why cannot society make amends to its rules to accept a freed black man to be a free American? Perhaps now is the time to end Negro man's suffering. Perhaps now is the time to bring him his rightfully deserved suffrage. Perhaps now is the time to make freedmen, who have been wrongfully subjected to imprisonment by color, free. The day that man can be back black and American. Now is the time to remove the veil that blocks our realization that we are the same as them. The time comes for everyone to realize the truth.
Well, folks, there you have it. W.E.B. Du Bois. Thank you so much for being here.
You're welcome. And remember, realistically speaking, slavery is wrong.
I was born in 1868, in turbulent time in America. You may have seen some of my writings, such as Slows of the Back.
What the hell? Well, isn't that a mouthful? Would you care to... I see. I have here a piece of your new writing. It would be a pleasure to hear you from.
Well, it'd be my pleasure to read it.